The study, which commenced in April 2021 and concluded in September 2021, was conducted by a team of consultants from CREOCEAN. This marine assessment forms part of the Ecosystem-Based Adaption Caribbean Biodiversity Fund Project, or CBF, being implemented by the SLNT and co-financed by the International Climate Initiative of the German Federal Ministry for Environment, Nature Conservation, and Nuclear Safety through KFW.
The St. Lucia National Trust is responsible for the Pigeon Island National Landmark, which includes the terrestrial management of the area. But the management of the marine area has been grossly overlooked, and the National Trust thought it necessary to undertake an assessment of the area to determine exactly what resources there are and how they are being impacted by anthropogenic factors and climate change. So we looked and recognized that the last assessment that was done for the Rodney Bay area, which included some areas of Pigeon Island, was in the 1990s, so this is way overdue. And the project that was done in the 1990s was the Atria project. So the National Trust recognized that this information presently is outdated, and there was presently need to do a comprehensive study and assessment of the marine ecosystems.
Among the remarkable findings of this study was the observation of healthy colonies of species of coral, including elkhorn coral.
It was indeed very eye-opening. It showed us that some of the coral is actually healthy and doing well. We found stands of a species called Acropora palmata, which is elkhorn coral. And this coral had been decimated by a bacterial disease in the 80s throughout the Caribbean. So it was indeed surprising and, you know, very heartening to know that this species is doing very well at Pigeon Island. And the consultants have actually recommended that we should undertake a restoration exercise, which would include transplanting some of the healthy species of Acropora to other locations around Pigeon Island.
The report also highlights that during the study, no live queen conch and white sea urchins was present in the marine area, and only aged dead conch shells were found. These species are critical to the health of both coral reefs and seagrass beds.
As well, the lobsters at Pigeon Island seem to be under severe pressure, because the only ones that were found around Pigeon Island were juvenile. So it shows clearly that we have to do some further work and further assessments of the species found around Pigeon Island. In addition to that, the consultants also stated that there are other factors that may be affecting the reef and the seagrass beds around Pigeon Island. These include invasive species like an invasive seagrass that has come in from the Mediterranean, the lionfish, and also a brittle star species, a type of starfish, as well as water quality issues. There are high presence of nitrates and phosphates, which are coming from runoff from the mainland St. Lucia. And then one of the issues as well that the consultants stressed was the presence of litter and solid waste that was found in the area.
Some of the pressures on the Pigeon Island marine ecosystems that were observed while the study was being conducted include the use of sun cream and related sunscreen agents by beach users, which may impact the corals, increased fishing pressure through recreational and small-scale fishing, lost fishing gear which could continue to ghost fish, unregulated mooring of large yachts, anchor damage to reefs and seagrass beds, and macro waste consisting mainly of plastic bottles, plastic glasses, aluminum cans, and tires. The assessment also revealed that the passage of numerous boats at excessive speed and speedboats with towed buoys are generating high levels of noise pollution in the marine area, which can impact marine fauna, such as the turtles, and the speed of the vessels constitutes, moreover, a real threat for the people who swim from the beach or yachts. The study recommends, among other things, the need to develop and implement a management plan for the area, installation of permanent moorings, vessel speed limits, and rehabilitating and monitoring of the elkhorn coral population through transplanting. For the DBS News World, I am Zane Romulus.